And finally, in the spirit of Christmas, with help from the University of Hawaii Athletic Department, Phillies outfielder Shane Victorino, pro surfer Keikoa Uemura, and the Island Television family, Merry Christmas, everybody, and enjoy the world premiere of Hawaii's Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer.
Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer
had a very shiny nose.
And if you ever saw it,
you'd even say it glows.
It's like a light bulb.
Then all the reindeer
loved him. Oh, there you
try. All of the other reindeer
used to laugh and call him names.
Like Pinocchio.
They never wiped for Rudolph.
Joining any reindeer games. You gotta pick it up, PJ.
Okay, enough of the Christmas stuff. Will somebody break it down for us?
Stop, collaborate, and listen. This be Nash with this brand new invention.
Okay, maybe not.
Then one foggy Christmas Eve,
Santa came to say,
ho, ho, ho.
Rudolph,
with your nose so bright,
won't you guide
my sleigh tonight?
Then all the other reindeer.
What? Then all the reindeer loved him.
As they shouted out with glee,
yippee!
Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer.
He'll go down in history.
Like Columbus. Yeah.
Merry Christmas, Hawaii.
Merry Christmas, Hawaii. Aloha.
It's tough to describe exactly what the 2007 Warrior football team meant to the state of Hawaii.
But if there's one motto that best sums up the most amazing year in the program's history, simply put, the Warriors chose to believe.
And fans soon followed suit, believing that UH was destined for great things. Even critics had to give credit to Hawaii.
Ranked and respected, the Warriors finished perfect on the season.
So without further ado, we present KGMB9's top 9 Warrior moments of the year.
Number 9 actually begins where 2006 left off, with mounting speculation that Colt Brennan would forgo his senior year at Hawaii for the NFL. Colt ended up passing on the pros.
The 8th spot belongs to number 7, Devon Best. Had a record-breaking All-American season. In his third year, Best became the WAC's all-time leader in receptions. Plus, Devon hauled in a school record 15 catches against Boise State.
Backup quarterback Tyler Grunke earns the 7th spot. With Colt injured, Grunke was called to start against Charleston Southern and Nevada. But it's versus the Wolfpack that he really rallied to keep the dream season alive. The junior accounted for 3 touchdowns and led UH to the game-winning drive.
Number 6 is actually worth 121. That was a touchdown record held by Ty Detmer before Colt passed it with a 6-yard touchdown strike to Ryan Bryce Mullen against Boise State. Brennan passed the mark in his 36th game as a Warrior, or 10 fewer games than Detmer had.
Making the countdown at number 5, the Warriors' entire defensive squad. Hawaii ranked 93rd in 2006, but under defensive coordinator Greg McMackin, the Warriors moved up to 33rd in 2007. UH allowed 349 yards of offense a game and only 24 points per contest.
Dan Kelly's foot belongs at number 4. Against La Tech, Kelly's 49-yarder sent UH into OT, allowing Hawaii to open its season with a road victory. Then at Nevada, after being iced twice, the junior confident kicked a 45-yarder to beat the Wolfpack and improve Hawaii to 10-0 for the first time since 1925.
Brennan's third place finish in the Heisman race comes in at 3rd. Florida QB Tim Tebow would take the trophy, but Colt would finally get that prestigious trip to New York. Brennan was the highest Heisman finalist out of a non-BCS conference in 13 years.
Number 2 goes to Hawaii's first outright WAC championship. It didn't hurt that the win came against rival Boise State in front of a sold-out crowd at the Aloha Stadium. The offense racked up almost 600 total yards, and the defense stepped up, holding Heisman candidate Ian Johnson to just 11 yards rushing in the second half.
What else could go at number 1 than Hawaii's perfect season and its first BCS bowl berth? UH ended up 10th in the BCS standings to score a date at the Sugar Bowl versus SEC opponent Georgia. Hawaii was the only team in college football to go undefeated in 2007. The Warriors came back from 21 points down to defeat Washington and finish at 12-0. It's hard to imagine anything could compare to this undefeated season.
But things could be that much sweeter with a win over Georgia at the Sugar Bowl on New Year's Day.
So stay tuned for our reports. We'll be there along with Steve Uehara for the historic BCS Bowl.
We wish you a safe and happy holiday season.
And of course, best of luck to the Warriors in New Orleans.
That still gives me chicken skin. Amazing. Oh, such an amazing season.
I hope our sports team remembered to pack lots of warm winter clothes.
Yes, it's going to be cold in New Orleans. They get down to 40 degrees there. Fortunately for us, we don't get that low. And in fact, we're looking at windy and wet conditions. A wet trade pattern is in store for us this week. By the weekend, our winds should weaken a bit. But for now, it should be drier as well. And although we'll see some winter Namaka showers, you know, they should be concentrated in the morning and evening hours.
So nothing too serious.
Nothing too serious, but a little more rain than we're used to.
All right, thanks, Malika. And finally tonight, imagine getting your haircut while singing some of your favorite songs. You can do it now at this new Karaoke Beauty Salon. It opened up a few months ago in Mexico. The owner says it happened by accident, but soon became a success. In fact, the owner has decided to open a second salon, which will feature even more karaoke songs. And I know that Malika has a beautiful singing voice, but I think I'll stick to singing alone in my car with my favorite tunes on the radio.
That sounds dangerous to me. I don't know. They have...